We're in Iowa, the Hawkeye State at Kinnick Stadium, the site for this college football matchup. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Fires out to his wideout. He's tackled right around the 40.
Middle linebacker came on a blitz, which can be very disruptive. Sometimes a quarterback will get happy feet when they see that coming. But not this guy. He's very composed and can deliver under a pass rush.
From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. Tackle at the 43.
Gain of three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down. My game.
Ready! Blue 88. Blue 88. Check, check. Thunder!
And down he goes at the 42-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
From the 42-yard line, first down.
Mike eight.
Brought down at the 21. About the 19-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From the 19-yard line, second down.
Four down. Mike eight.
Tackle made at the eight.
He gets another set of downs and, more importantly, opens up a whole host of play calling possibilities for the coaching staff.
Gets to about the 8-yard line.
No gain on the play. That brings him second and goal.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Four down. Mike eight.
Let's go.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That makes it third and goal.
It's third and goal, and they're about 4 yards out. Pitch out, got the corner. Touchdown, Iowa! He makes the PAT. A 9-play, 76-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. Iowa lines up for the kickoff. Pacheco takes it from the 6. He's taken down at the 29. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Fires out to his receiver, and he is drilled at the 43-yard line.
First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 43.
You know, Brad, the defensive coordinator does a nice job with the coverage call here. Everybody's in position to be able to make the play. The only problem is they didn't intercept the football. That's something that they got to be happy with the coverage, but not happy with the result.
Gets it out quickly. And he's tackled around the 43-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
This comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Quick throw. That's a great tackle at the 34-yard line.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And he's taken down at the 38-yard line. The lineman had a big push there to get in the backfield and bring him down.
And once he gets moving, there's no stopping him. This guy is so big and strong that he's almost impossible to block with one guy.
Five wide. He's out of bounds at the 34. It's fourth down. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. He gets it up, and he nails the long field goal.
You know, I was wondering if he's going to get a chance to kick one of those. We saw him warming up from 60 yards before the game.
7-3, Iowa. Rutgers is lining up to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
From their own 26-yard line, second down, Iowa holds a four-point lead. The halfback with a carry. And they make the stop around the 27-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. Third down.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Three down. Mike eight. Mike 88. Blue 88.
They'll bring him down at the 29-yard line. The draw play gets maybe 2 yards.
Fourth down.
Young, back to return it. And down he goes at the 37. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Throws this one out to the left. He's tackled around the 34-yard line. After a quarter of play, we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Hawkeyes lead it by four. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter.
Let's go, D, let's go. Let's get there. Ready.
Short over the middle. Tackle around the 24-yard line.
Call it a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and
inches. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Makes the grab and steps out right away.
That makes it first and goal.
run there.
That brings up second and goal.
That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights. Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And the safety with the interception. And he's leveled at the 32-yard line.
That is exactly the kind of play you want to see from a safety. He needs to be able to read the play and then make the interception.
From the 32-yard line, first down. Rutgers holds a field goal lead. And he hits him hard at the 39.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
Gets rid of this one. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 22. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He wants it all, going long. Missed him.
It might not be a lot of fun, but when you're a receiver, you've got to be able to take some hits and hang on to the football. It's just part of the game.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously. But at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with. Because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game. The offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
He fights forward to about the 23. Second down and seven. Ball in the 23. Stood tall there.
Well, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
Young awaiting the return. Oh, excellent punt. Young fields at the 31. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Rutgers is up a field goal. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. First down. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. Makes his way out to about the 15. That's a gain of 18 on the play. First down. From the 15-yard line, it's first down. Nice run up the middle. So he calls his own number and gets about 6 yards. The Scarlet Knights taking their first time out of the half. And that run got stuck.
Yeah, you're right. The defense definitely won the battle at the line of scrimmage there.
From the 13-yard line, third down. Rutgers has a three-point lead. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. That one sailed on him.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. There's a fumble. Picks up the fumble. Tries to get around the corner. Tackle made at the 20. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. Field will be reversed. First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 19. There's a strike complete. He's down. About a 7-yard pickup that time on the pass.
Hey, they picked up a nice gain of 7 yards on that play. Great pass.
Quickly, and he's got his man. He's pushed out of bounds at the 31. From their own 31-yard line, first down. Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
Man left, man left.
Nice play across the middle. Brought down at about the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line. First down. Quick pass. Here's an opening. Touchdown. Huge play. Here's the extra point that can give them the lead. And he hits the PAT. So that's a 5-play, 82-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
So our score, 14-13. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Pacheco from the 7. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
That's a great tackle at the 42.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
We've got a first and 10.
Ball on their own 42. And he just gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers.
And he's tackled around the 36-yard line. Five wide. He's under pressure. Throws on a run, and he's got his wide receiver. And down he goes
around the 14-yard line.
Pass complete and taken down immediately.
That's the end of the half, and believe it or not, folks, it's still anyone's ball game. Iowa's up by one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
He's to the 20. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
And he tackles him hard at the 18.
Well, I think the linebacker here does such a good job of disguising his blitz. As a linebacker in college football, one of your biggest responsibilities is being able to get to the quarterback. And that time, he timed it up perfectly, was able to get through the offensive line and put the pressure on the quarterback.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Here they go on the draw, and they'll lose yards. Set. He's got to throw it in a hurry.
Throws complete and he's hit right away. Nice yardage on the run back. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Iowa with a one-point lead. Quick pass, man open, and he dropped it. from their own 47-yard line. Second down. Stanley fakes a handoff. He airs it out. And he's got the junior. He's taken down at the 15-yard line. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Bring him down around the 12-yard line. Sargent gains around 3 yards on that draw play.
You won't break or bend this linebacker. He won't miss that tackle too often.
Fires quickly to the tight end. Touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he converts the extra point. To kick this one away. Pacheco fields it at the 7. Gets to about the 27-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. It's second and 11. Ball on their own 26. Now he tries to buy some time. Tackle around the 38-yard line. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what, in today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Throws out and through his hands. Second and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. They'll get him for a loss.
Man, did he play that perfectly or what? As a linebacker, you have to be able to read the offense and make a quick diagnosis, which is exactly what he did on that play.
Going long. Got a man. Watch out here. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights. They need to tie it up here. That's exactly why they're going for 2. He's in for the conversion. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 24-yard line. Kirk, not sure what went on in the locker room at halftime, but both offenses have really come ready to play in this third quarter.
I think that's really what separates a good team from a great team, is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and come out and being able to execute. And so far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that.
Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
That'll make it second and seven.
Second down and seven coming up here. Ball on the 28-yard line.
Let's go!
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop around the 43-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 43. Here's the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 43. There's a strike complete. And he shoved out of bounds around the 28-yard line. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. He's tackled right around the 16-yard line. Made at about the 5-yard line. First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. They line up in the jumbo set. And he makes it out to about the 5-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. The PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From the 8-yard line, he's out to the 30. He got hit hard. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. That's 3 down and 1 to go. The Hawkeyes with a touchdown lead. In this very pivotal fourth quarter. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Here we go!
couldn't hang on here in the fourth quarter. And this is what power football is all about, folks. Quick throw to the tight end. Brought down right around the 46-yard line.
Number 11 on the tackle.
From the 46-yard line, it's first down. Run and he's brought down.
Gain of 5 on the play. That'll make it second and 4.
Ready, green and 8.
Nice run up the middle. So the halfback gets some decent yards and a first down.
Good running and a strong push to get into the second level of that defense.
From the 35-yard line. First down. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
This is the eighth play of this drive. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. And he's tackled around the 30-yard line. From the 30-yard line, it's third down. Just throws this one away. First and 10. Ball on the 20. Just under 3 to go in regulation.
Here we go. Green 95. Green 95.
Tackled for a loss. So the quarterback keeps it on the option, but he'll lose a yard. Here's the 12th play of the drive. He scrambled. Loose football. And they fall on the loose ball. They'll knock him down for a loss. Wow, very close to turning it over, but they'll keep possession of the football.
Way to play heads up out there. That's just one more reason to play to the whistle.
Play 13 of the current drive. Hit out of bounds at the 10. Here we go again. It's fourth down, and they're going for it. They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. Tosses it out.
Touchdown, Rutgers!
Run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offense coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
We'll be tied with the extra point, and he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Boy, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time?
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Just over 2 minutes in the game.
Blue 14.
Throws complete. He's got space to work. And down he goes at the 34.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Quick throw, and he's got the halfback again. He's taken down around the 41-yard line. They get about 7 yards on the pass and pick up a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
Throw's complete. He's got room to work. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. It fly. That's incomplete. He caught it, but failed to get that one necessary foot in.
That's an outstanding catch, and he just missed making a big-time play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Wants to go long and does. Nice catch on that one. Looks like they didn't get the playoff quick enough.
Delay of game, offense.
A little over a minute in the game. And he hits the PAT. All lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23-yard line.
Well, I think I've lost track, but I think that's at least five possessions in which the offenses have scored. I don't know if anybody's going to step up defensively in this game or not.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Zips it to the back, and he's taken down around the 33-yard line. Rutgers just took their first time out. 3, maybe 4 yards on the pass.
He took what the defense gave him that time, which is okay. It keeps the yards to go a little bit more manageable.
Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. That's a great tackle at the 41. He's up to 300 yards passing.
You can tell the quarterback's done a really good job of preparing because he's read the defense like a pro all day long.
Looks middle, got his back. Tackle around the 48-yard line. Steps up into the pocket, and they've got him.
Check, check, check.
And he stops the clock with a spike.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going. Quick toss. And they couldn't hook up on that one. They come out on an empty backfield. Passes to his tailback again. Wow, what a battle and what a stop right there. Congratulations to that defense. That's going to be the ball game. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
The Scarlet Knights using their third and final timeout. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. Should do it. Our final tally in this one. Iowa 35, Rutgers 28. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.